What's going on, everyone? Austin John Place here, and today we're going to be talking about pretty much one of the first useful exploits in Pokemon Brilliant Diamond Shining Pearl. I don't remember exactly where I heard this, but a bug is a part of the code of a game that's not executed correctly. An exploit is when someone repeatedly abuses this bug for gain. So I would classify this as an exploit. I was discussing on Reddit a little bit, and one person named Bammy166 kind of just found this exploit by accident. They spoke to the 32 NPCs, interacted with the Spiritomb, caught Spiritomb, realized it wasn't the nature that he wanted, reset the game, his autosaves were on, so when he respawned in, it already autosaved the game, and he had Spiritomb. However, he was able to encounter Spiritomb again. Because normally, if you do that, if you encounter Spiritomb, you drop down a hard save, and then if you interact with it again, you have to have another old keystone, you have to speak to 32 additional NPCs, it could be the same 32 that you did the first time, and then you can encounter Spiritomb. But it seems like there's sort of a glitch in the game's code that the autosave is put down before the flag. And the flag removes the fact that, you know, all the criteria was met, and then it resets that you have to put the keystone in and repeat the whole process. And just like everything else on the internet, I'm skeptical of it until I do my own research, as every intelligent person should be, except when you watch my videos. If you watch my videos, I did the research. You're fine. Trust me. My boy Hoodlum Callum reached out to me and was like, hey, I did your method. I'm at, I think he was at 6 badges right now. And with 6 badges, he was able to repeat this process. We actually just had a call a couple hours ago and we did this. By the way, shout out to him for helping me out with this. So he spoke to all of his NPCs. He put down a hard save right here before interacting with the tower that would give you the Gia or whatever it's called. Whatever the thing says. The Yala. That's it, the Yala. He does the Yala and Spiritomb is here. Right? The Pokemon is then successfully caught. Being registered to the Pokedex, no nickname. Pay attention to the top right of the screen. Now saving. That means that it was autosaved properly. From here, you turn the game off and you reboot the game up. From rebooting the game up, you can interact with it again and then get another Spiritomb encounter. Now, if you're skeptical of this, as you can see, he's been able to get a few Spiritombs this way. Why you may want this many Spiritombs, I'm not really too sure. Well, one, if the update for Surprise Trade, which I assume is going to be in version 1.2, goes live before Christmas, you know, these my fellow experienced gamers can catch a whole bunch of these Spiritombs, which you know how much of a pain in the butt it is, catch a whole bunch of the Spiritombs, and then surprise trim away to a whole bunch of kids who's starting off the game. Spiritomb's a dope Pokemon to have at the beginning of the game. Alternatively, you could just, you know, breed it down or whatever, but these are just easy, legit caught Spiritombs, not bred or anything. Very necessary. And you can see right off of the bat, they're all unique encounters. They all have different genders, they all have different HP. So they obviously all have independent chances at a shiny roll. Do I consider this a legitimate or fast way to do a shiny roll? No. But you can, you know, have intentions of doing the surprise trade thing and then maybe also subsequently encounter a shiny. Who knows? And it's important to note that he's not jumping back in time or anything. You'll see right here that this Magmar has 17 hit points. Then you're going to see Magmar right here take more damage, lived on 1 health because, you know, he loves him. It's a female Magmar. She loves him. And then in this next encounter, you'll see that the Magmar still has 1 health. In my professional gamer yet extremely novice programming opinion here, he's going into the battle, encountering the Spiritomb. Catching the Spiritomb. The battle transpires regularly, right? After that's done, the game then puts down that it wants to put down an autosave. It puts down the autosave, and then the game is removing the flag. Therefore, when you reload from the autosave, it's before the flag was removed. So that autosave now becomes the new starting point. And then going forward, the battle transpires, everything else, already caught one spirit tomb, and then another autosave happens, and then the flag is removed. You jump back by reloading that autosave, and the flag is never removed. There's gonna be some people watching this video that the gears are already turning. I'm not one of them. But the gears are already turning on. If we're gonna call this the Spirit Tomb exploit, which I think is a nice thing to do, because we don't know any other uses for this application. If this Spirit Tomb exploit allows the autosave to go down before the flag is removed, what other instances can this be done for? Can this be done for other static encounters? Like legendaries and stuff? I doubt that would make it through the programming and testing. Who knows? There's maybe some applications to this, there may not be some applications to this. It would appear that there was one thing that broke the chain of being able to go back and re-catching for different natures or whatever else. And that was when a Pokemon evolved after this screen. And my theory is the game sees that it's going to be the Pokemon is caught, the flag is removed, and then the evolution happens. So it stalls the autosave until after the evolution, maybe? I don't know. But that was able to break the chain. Now let's talk about what I see being the one immediate useful thing of this exploit. You want to play through the game with Spiritomb. Cool. You also want to shiny hunt Spiritomb. All right, don't recommend it, but you can. You can do all the grinding early, you know, in only the one, two, or three areas, get all your NPCs. After you have all your NPCs, make sure you turn autosaves on, put the hard save in front of the tower, catch your Spiritomb, make sure you do it that the autosave appears at the top soon as the battle is done, immediately reload the game, your flag is still active, and then go about playing the game. Go enjoy the game, become champion, get the national decks, do whatever you want to do, and whenever you're ready to come do this shiny hunt, you could just do it. You just come here and re-encounter the Pokemon. So unlike the many people who are currently stuck in the first 2 minutes of the game because they're shiny hunting their starter, and I feel so bad for you guys, I really do. You can just go about this, all right? There you go. I don't know what other uses or applications this has right now. Personally, I'm a little busy making videos to further test this on different things. But if this ends up becoming a useful thing, definitely hit me up on Twitter with your experience. I'd be happy to cover these subjects. And who knows, maybe we might be able to do some pretty fun stuff. Immediately gets flashbacks of the Trial of the Sword glitch and Pokemon Max Raid dens. Well, my dudes, if you found this video helpful or informative or just plain entertaining, do me a favor, hit the thumbs up button down below. If you're new to the channel, be sure to subscribe, turn on notifications. Until next time, Austin John out.